Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. You may or may not know that I have rosacea. I've had what I would consider mild rosacea, but I do have a lot of redness as well. If you see me apply products, you'll see that my skin kind of instantly starts flushing. It's very reactive and that redness would usually go away, but every so often my rosacea just flushes and I have like a straight week of just red skin. And I often get comments, people be like, oh my god, what happened to your skin? And I have to explain, I have rosacea, like it flares and it doesn't flare. Like, I want to share my journey. I hate when people say journey. My experience with rosacea, redness, and how I've pretty much come to a really happy place of it. I will say, from what I know, rosacea is pretty much uncurable, but I kind of like, I'll come to that in a minute. I want to share the ways that I have improved my own personal rosacea and redness, just to give you maybe a little bit of inspiration for what might work for you. I have spent a lot of money over the span of 3 years. That's money on products, on specific treatments. Some worked, some didn't work at all. I'm going to share that today. I have had and do still have some illnesses that could be playing an issue in my redness. Things that I feel like are more than just what I'm applying to my skin, which a lot of people seem to be the go-to. I used to think that my redness and rosacea was caused by the sheer amount of products I test, which I don't think is necessarily not the reason. I definitely think it doesn't help. I know there are products that I can't use because my skin will react to it. But yeah, I'm going to share some quick temporary fixes, almost an instant relief from redness, and some longer term things that really, really help. Okay, let's get into the first thing. This is a treatment that is fairly new, by a couple of months, but I'm absolutely in love with, and probably the best treatment I've ever done for my skin. This is the Dermalux Flex MD, and this is essentially an LED mask. Very expensive. This cost me £1,895. I don't spend money like this. I spend my money on sensible things. This is the most money I've ever spent on something cosmetic. But you know, it's also my job, so I'm trying to kid myself that I needed this for work. essentially, I do. So this is basically an LED mask. Like, you have your red and you have your blue lights, but you also have near infrared. And they say on the website, it's a 7 targeted treatments for a range of skin concerns, including anti-aging, rosacea, eczema, acne and acne scars, muscle joint and more. This is obviously more powerful than your at-home LED mask. This has 360 LED bulbs, 120 blue, 120 red and 120 near infrared. From what I know, a lot of people say that blue targets one thing, red targets another, but I feel like it's not as simple as that. I feel like there's a bit more nuance to it. I'm not 100% sure, but the Dr. Lee channel, Dr. Maxfield and Dr. Shah, have an amazing video all about LED masks and like their favorites and kind of a bit of an explanation behind what it all does. I'll link it below so you can go and check it out for yourself. And you know, I've always liked the idea of LED mask treatments, but I'm just someone who, I can't do it every night and I don't really reap the benefits from having this mask on my face. You've really got to dedicate to it and I just feel like I never do. But the reason I bought this one is a story. So I got this done professionally. I had it done in a professional location. It's kind of like an added-on freebie to a treatment I was already having. I spoke to the woman about, you know, my concerns. I was like, you know, I got rosacea. It's been really flushing, flaring up recently, and I'm getting these hot flushes. And she recommended the near infrared. And I'll be honest with you, I do not know what near infrared is. I do not know. So I'm asking you to help. I think it's just red light, but something different. I really don't know. I'm sorry. I should have done research. But I was under this near infrared for about 30 minutes. The treatment was done and she gave me the mirror and she was like, take a look. And I was like, yeah, you know what? My skin does look a little less red. However, I had just had Botox. So I was like, maybe my flushing, I don't know why, but you know, I was looking here and I only get Botox here. I actually don't know, but on my forehead. I was like, you know, I don't know, like my skin always gets a little bit irritated when I have needles in, obviously. Maybe my skin's just calming down. But you know, my skin did look less red. So that evening, about 8 hours later, I was looking at my skin whenever I do my skincare routine. And I was like, why am I not as red as usual? Usually in the evening, I'm flaring up really bad just before I do my skincare routine. And I do my skincare routine in the same place every day, so I know what my skin looks like, you know? It wasn't like a trick of the light. My skin just wasn't red. I was like, it can't be the Dermalux thing. It can't be. I've had like one treatment. So I looked on their website and I was looking at before and afters, and the before and afters are crazy. Like, the difference that somebody had just within 8 treatments is a lot. And I had one, I was like, okay, maybe this is good. Maybe it's good. There were really extreme transformations with just 8 sessions. So I was like, maybe my skin did react really well to it in just one. So after a couple of days thinking about it, I was like, I'm just going to do it. I'm going to commit to it. I'm going to buy it. My job is talking about skincare. It's not an overly stupid thing to buy. You know, I'll post an extra video. I should be fine. Hi, future me. Excuse my hair. I'm filming another video. And after this, I'm getting ready for bed and I'm going to use the, I always forget its name, the Flex. The Dermalux Flex. So I tried to film myself using it, but despite it being very travel friendly, it's actually kind of clunky to film. So you get this headrest, like so. So whatever surface you decide to lay on, it's quite comfortable. Bag that it comes in. This is it. All the LEDs are on there. Then this is, I probably shouldn't be swinging that. This is your control panel. It looks very old fashioned. It reminds you of that little robot that you used to play with in like primary school. Like you plug it in here, there's your plug. It comes with a plug, it's just in my room. It goes like this. See what I mean? It's like not easy to film with. And you kind of like sit inside it like this, you know? I have seen videos where people are literally just like holding it without the base on it and holding it on their chest. They're holding it on the rest of their body. And they're kind of like, so yeah, 30 minutes under that. I've literally only used the near infrared because it works so well. I have tried the red, I tried all of them once, at least once. And it's fine, I can't say anything about that because I'm not using them enough, but the near infrared I feel is working really, really well. I've used this maybe 4 times a week for about 30 minutes for about 2 months now. And it's probably the only thing I've used that I've seen such a huge difference with. I should have took pictures. I'm terrible at taking pictures. But if you look back on my videos where I'm doing my skincare routine versus like how it looks now, you can see that that really aggressive redness isn't there. And I notice it in my everyday life. Like when I come back from a dog walk, I'm not as flared up. When I've eaten certain foods that I know flare me up, I'm not as flared up. I still don't risk it. But when I do happen to have a few drinks, I'm not flaring up as much. I don't see it as much here as I do now. I just don't see that aggressive redness. I do feel like this is along with some skincare, a change in skincare techniques, I guess you can say. Like I use a lot less aggressive actives now. I have a different approach to exfoliation and all my skincare really does focus on, not all my skincare, the majority of my skincare focuses on barrier repair, especially in the evening. I feel like that's helped in the long term, but the immediate, I hate saying immediate because like nothing really works immediately, but it's just the most change I've seen in a short space of time due to this LED light. And I use it because it's fucking expensive and I have to use it. I use it on clean skin. I go under for 30 minutes. I usually put a podcast on and fall asleep because I always use it in the evening. So time literally flies by. And then I finish my routine and go to bed. I'm not saying run out and buy this because it's nearly $2,000 and it's going to cure your rosacea. A lot of places offer this as a treatment. If you can afford to get it. Honestly, like, you know, this is not sponsored or that kind of stuff. It's one of the best things I've done for my rosacea. And I'm honestly not 100% sure why, I'll be honest with you. Because I've tried red light before. I've tried blue light. I've never tried near infrared, which I feel is just like a different version of red. I don't know. I don't know why it works, but it just really, really does. Let's talk about IPL because I did do some sessions of IPL and I was going to record the process of it. And I don't think it was a great idea for me in the end. At first, I was like, yeah, this is great because it did get rid of a lot of like the like little veiny bits you see, you know, like the burst blood vessels. You can kind of see it on my nose. But I spent a lot of time trying to cure the irritation on my skin and the redness. So I did look red a lot of the time and my skin was very bothered by it. But I also don't think I had a long enough session. I had maybe 2 sessions, then COVID hit, and then lockdown happened. And then even when lockdown was lifted, I still didn't want to go because I wasn't very well. I had the start of what I have now. I didn't know whether it was something that was going to make me sicker if I got COVID, if it could be potentially fatal if I had COVID. So I avoided London. I avoided going back to get this treatment done. I just didn't know why I was sick, so I didn't want to risk making it worse by getting COVID. But IPL for me, I just feel like wasn't the best route for that, for the flushing, which is really my main concern. So let's talk about that illness that it's not an illness, I have something going on, and food and gut and all that kind of stuff. Disclaimer, I do not know how accurate this is going to be. This is my personal experience with IBS, IBD, something else I'll talk about. If you want Food Science Babe here on YouTube and on TikTok offers some great kind of like science myth busting stuff. So definitely check her out, but I'm just going to talk about my personal experience and what I've been going through. As I mentioned at the beginning of the video, I often get asked about my rosacea and people are always like, oh, it's because you use so much skincare. And I don't think, Whilst that I don't think that helps, I do not think that's the reason I have rosacea. At first, I thought like an ordinary product gave me rosacea. And that's, I don't feel that's what happened. While a product exacerbated it for sure, I do not think, and made me flare up. I don't think that's what happened. My rosacea started when I had very bad, what I thought was GERD, like severe acid reflux. You know, there was a time I thought I was having heart attacks because it was so painful. I went to the hospital and they just told me I had GERD. So I took some tablets, omeprazole or something. Didn't help me. Well, I thought it did for a little bit, but it didn't help me at all. My diet was also terrible. But it was around that time that I started getting really bad facial flushes. I was diagnosed with maybe like 10 years ago, IBS, irritable bowel syndrome. I still would eat what I wanted. You know, I've been tested for other food intolerances. I just had IBS. So I was like, I'm just going to eat and deal with it the next day kind of thing. But around the time my rosacea started happening was when it started to really kind of interfere with my life. And I really had to be careful with what I was eating. Also around that time, my stress levels were starting to peak because I had moved out of London. I was trying to do YouTube full time. I was pretty much making a minimum wage. I was actually about to stop doing YouTube because I wasn't making great money until literally like 2 months later overnight. It just went crazy. But I was stressed. I was stressed. My stomach hurt all the time. And the more I think about it, the more I've spoken to professionals along the way, it makes sense that my rosacea is linked to my gut and my stress. For about 3 to 4 years now, I've had something called globus hystericus or globus sensation, which is the constant feeling of having to clear your throat, of having a lump in the back of your throat. Right now, it feels like I have a big ball of something here. And I often need to like take a minute, swallow like that, or like clear my throat. And after about 3 years of not knowing what this was, it's only kind of been properly diagnosed within the last year. I've had cameras down my throat, I've had blood tests, I've been on certain medicines for certain things. The doctors pretty much said it's due to stress. And I get that when I'm particularly stressed out, when I'm particularly busy, it gets to the point where like I'm finally relaxing in bed and it feels like I can't breathe. I have to kind of like take a minute to like slow down, literally tilt my neck right back and try and swallow and breathe and de-stress. And the more I looked into it, the more I found that this is something that's actually really kind of common amongst both freelancers. So anybody who is self-employed and has a stressful job or just, you know, kind of works nonstop all the time, but also people who use their voice for a living. So TV presenters, voice actors, singers, people who speak to the camera nonstop. It's pretty common. And as my job has gotten busier, my throat has gotten worse, my IBS has gotten worse, and my rosacea has been flaring up more. And I look back at my videos and I can see the more kind of popular my videos get, and the more I know back then that I was working more and more, the redder my skin's getting, the more my gut was getting bad. I had a colonoscopy recently because the pain was so bad. I actually thought it was cancer, I thought it was bowel cancer, because the stress levels were getting so bad and the pain was getting bad and my face was getting red and hot. The last 6 months or so, I've actually really managed to manage it, sort it all out, finally get a proper diagnosis, finally get all the tests I need to have done. I know my food triggers, I'm eating a lot better, I'm eating a lot of fermented foods for my stomach. I was taking supplements that never seemed to help. So I'm just kind of like eating, I do believe in the power of supplements, but they just didn't work for me. And I think especially with like healthy gut bacteria, it's really hard to kind of get the right ones. But I'm eating healthier now, I'm finding stress relief in my nail hobby. It's the only time I can really switch off and I can feel my stress levels coming down. I'm able to relax a lot easier now because I know I have to. I saw a vocal therapist to help me kind of like exercise my throat before filming, before using it to help relax it. And whilst it's not gone, and after this video, I will have to, you know, gently sip water, try and like warm down my throat, all that kind of stuff. I can manage it now and I'm less stressed. I'm eating better. And my rosacea doesn't flare up as much anymore. To coincide with the LED mask as well, it's hard to tell kind of like if it's just one thing, but I feel like I've made a good mix of things. Now, obviously this all costs money, as much as I would have got it done on the NHS. I went to a private doctor because I couldn't live with this constant lump and pain anymore in my stomach and in my throat. But noticing these triggers have massively helped with my redness and my rosacea. And once I was diagnosed and found all this information to help me, was given information, found out more online, just how like everyday people deal with what I have as well. These changes in my diet and my routines, in my stress levels, have really, really helped with my rosacea. I don't know if there's a science behind this. I don't know what it is. I know stress is linked to your gut. I know stress can make you flare up. So maybe it is just that. I'm living a less stressed life by, you know, just trying not to be stressed. I don't know. Listen, I could be speaking absolute bullshit, but these things I've done just happen to coincide with the lack of rosacea flare-ups. I have the weirdest triggers too. Peas, anything high in fiber, protein, sorry. Skincare, fragrance, spice doesn't flare me up. Alcohol does though, but yeah, it's been interesting. But yeah, I think mainly those smaller lifestyle changes have helped massively. The LED treatment seems to be working like that. I do feel like once you've used it, it looks really good. Your skin looks less red. And then like the next day, you're like, oh, the redness is back a little bit. But each time I do it, that redness comes back less and less. So I do feel like it is potentially something you need to keep up with. So let's actually talk about some products. And here's a mix of instant improvements, temporary improvements, and long-term benefits. I'm just really, really going to touch on this one again. Erborian CC Red Correct is one of the only color correcting products that sits comfortably on my rosacea, doesn't look like makeup that I'm comfortable using and going out with. Very, very good at canceling out redness. Azelaic acid has been a huge long-term benefit, mainly calming the redness that comes with that persistent flushing. I feel like I've not given azelaic acid enough of a try long term to be like, that's really helped my rosacea. Redness, yes. Rosacea, I need longer in general with, but I guess redness is part of the rosacea, if that makes sense. If skincare wasn't my job, this is a product I'd be using as one of my main products to help my skin, you know? Okay, and here's one that makes an instant difference. This is prescription only, Mirvaso Gel. Within 30 minutes, this temporarily gets rid of all redness on your face. I'm not gonna show you it on my face and I'll tell you why in a minute, but the before and afters on the website are true and extremely accurate. Extremely accurate. There are videos on YouTube where you can see it working in kind of real time, sped up because it takes a while. It just gets rid of it temporarily, but your redness completely goes. So on the website, they say the active substance in Mirvaso, bremonidine tartrate, works by attaching to receptors called alpha-2 adrenergic receptors. Some of the cells are blood vessels of the skin and activating them. This causes these blood vessels to narrow, which reduces the blood flow to the face, thus decreasing redness. Now, when I first used this, I was like, oh my God, wow. Like I actually couldn't believe it. It completely got rid of any redness at all. Here's a lot of things I don't like about it though. One, once you've had redness on your face and rosacea, seeing yourself completely clear of any kind of uneven tone looks weird. And I'll be honest, I missed my redness. I was like, I look flat. My skin looks yellow. There's no depth. There's no definition. There's no character to my face. I look flat. I just look like I was wearing I don't know, it was really weird. I didn't like it so much. I also have like these burst blood vessels, which I'm seeing a lot more as I use the LED mask because it's kind of getting rid of the redness that kind of surrounds them. So they're showing up more, which IPL would be good for. So maybe that's my next thing. Now these are getting more obvious, but they don't go with the Mirvaso cream. So you're seeing those and they're way more obvious because usually they're surrounded by redness and they kind of fade into the background. So yeah, this only lasts about, I think it's recorded 8 hours maximum. For me, this lasts until I basically wash my face. But what a lot of people are saying is that once it's gone, the next day you get a flush that is like 10 times worse than you've ever had. On their website, they say that this could be the case. Maybe you are getting a really bad rebound flush, or you're seeing your face so clear for the first time in ages that when your redness comes back, it's a bit of a shock. You're like, oh, I didn't realize how red my skin was. There is, when I was researching this before I asked my doctor about it, I did do some research and there's a guy online who pretty much said that his skin was ruined by Mirvaso gel. And now he's kind of like got all these really bad rebound flushes and his journey trying to stop those rebound flushes. So it really is hit or miss with this one. I personally found that I wasn't sure whether I was rebound flushing, but maybe a coincidence, a few days later, I would get a hot, hot flush, like to the point where I'd have ice packs on my face. It was really bad. So I personally do not put this on my skin anymore. I don't feel like I have bad enough rosacea. Even though it was prescribed, I feel like my rosacea isn't bad enough to red enough even to warrant the change that that gives my skin, if that makes sense. Like, no one's gonna notice other than me. But if you do have very severe rosacea, that could be a real instant relief for you, and you may actually really, really, really like it. So I wouldn't say don't try it because you're going to get rebound flushes and it's going to ruin your face. I'll say try it. If you get rebound flush, stop using it. The rebound flush isn't bad and going to last you forever. So there we go. I hope that made sense. To kind of sum up, I feel like food, stress, lifestyle are, I kept saying like small changes, but they're bigger changes I had to make in order to see a long-term benefit that I feel like I'm seeing. The LED near infrared, it's just been the best thing I've ever used. Honestly, it's been the best thing. Really, really pricey. I wish there was, there might be an at home alternative for near infrared. If there is, let me know, a cheaper version. And there are a few products that do the job, but you know, it's like a long journey. When I first had rosacea, I was trying to find like all these instant fixes. I thought IPL was going to get rid of it. You know, it didn't. There's no real way to get rid of it. It's about managing it and learning your triggers, which is a really boring answer, but it's definitely something that I've learned to take a bit more seriously, I think, as well as just kind of like checking your own health here and there, you know. But yes, if you have redness, rosacea, both, let me know in the comments down below. If there's any products or treatments that you swear by that really worked for you, please share it and let us know. You can watch some product reviews here, some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.